Hey guys, what is up? Today we are going to be talking about email domain variations and deliverability. What I've done is I've opened up smartreach.io, which is where I was recently running some campaigns, and I wanted to show you the domain variations that we have set up and how they work. So let's come into this campaign as an example, and we'll go over to email setup. And when you select the emails that we can send from, we have coldlytics.co, coldlytics.io, coldlytics.net, and coldlytics.org. And you'll notice that I've set this max emails per day to 50. And so what happens is we're sending out a limited number of emails from each email account. So if I wanted to send 200, I would send emails from each of these domains, and that's why they're here. So 50 emails from each gives me a capacity of 200 emails per day. And then when I go to launch the campaign, I actually enable warm up. So I'll see if I can show you guys that right now. All right, so we're here in our warm up settings. So they call it soft start inside of SmartReach. So the length of days that you start the warm up for, I usually do 10 to 14 days. And then I start with around 5 on the first day and it ramps up. And what you're doing is you're telling the email servers that this is a new account, but it's being used with normal behavior. So you're taking a fresh email account and trying to make it look as humanly used as possible, not like a spam account where you've come in and you've blasted a whole bunch of emails out of a brand new account, affecting your domain reputation and deliverability as a result. Warm-up is critical to having a successful campaign. And the reason I went with 50 is that as an upper limit for volume per day, is that Google is particular about the volume that you send. And I've seen good success with sending 50 emails or less per day inside of Google accounts. Now, if you have a Microsoft account or you have Proton Mail or something different, it may have a different deliverability ratio. But for me, I found that 50 per day per account works well. So that's why I have mine set up. They're all in individual workspace accounts. The next thing I wanted to talk to you guys about is email blacklisting. So what can happen is when you're sending cold emails, people will mark your emails as spam, especially if they're not well crafted. And you will get your email potentially submitted to a blacklist like Spam House. And they keep massive global records of different accounts that have been flagged for spam. And it can be very difficult to get your email removed off that list. And that's why it's so important to use a different domain. That's why we do domain variations, is to protect your domains. That way, if you end up on a blacklist like Spam House, you are protected. And that is critical in the longevity of your business, because it is inevitable at some point in cold email, you will get put on one of these blacklists. It happens to everybody. So you should just plan for that ahead. And that's part of why email deliverability and email domain variations is such a big topic, because there's a lot of nuances that people don't realize when they first start sending cold emails. If you guys have questions about anything that I've shown you in this video or anything that we've talked about, or you would like a specific video on another area around email deliverability and email domain variations, you can send me a message on our website at coldlytics.com and click on the blue chat bubble in the bottom right corner. This goes directly to myself and my co-founder. I'd be happy to answer your questions. Have a fantastic rest of your day. Thanks for watching.